We are designing with intention. Why is this important? Because when you design with intention, that is how you create a dress that is for you. As opposed to when we were little kids, right? I used to love fashion plates and I would go look through the magazines and trace the pictures and I would just randomly draw things. Random does not work when you're spending dozens and dozens of hours and hundreds or maybe thousands of dollars making a dress for yourself or your client. That's why we want to design with intention so that you have clarity on one, what you want, two, who you're designing it for, be it yourself, your daughters, or your client, and three, how to do it the most efficiently so that you don't waste a lot of time and don't waste a lot of money. Because making these dresses can be very expensive, both time-wise and money-wise. All right, so what helps you design with intention? One, you do not want to make hasty decisions. As you are planning your design, treat it as if you were going to paint a wall in your house, or you know, redo decorating in your house, or buy an automobile, or plan a big holiday vacation. If you were doing any of those big ticket items, you would not make hasty decisions. You wouldn't just say, oh, I think I'm gonna buy this ticket and go to Tahiti today. Designing your dress and skate dresses also takes planning because it could take you a while to decide what you want. It could take a while to get fabrics, and or you don't want to pay overnight shipping because overnight shipping is through the roof these days post-COVID. Number two, know why. Why do I have balloons? I thought I don't know why. I just said know why and they appear and I don't know why. But with regards to your dance and skate dresses, not Zoom, know why you like a part of a dress and why you dislike a part of a dress. Why is this useful? Because if you look at a dress and go, well, I don't really like that, and you cannot pinpoint what about that dress you do not like, then you have a chance of putting that element that you don't like on your dress and not even knowing it. Okay. Whereas if you know exactly what you do not like about specific dresses, and we'll run through a general list of design elements, and what you do like about a dress, it is easier and faster and more efficient for you to design a dress that you like. What a novel concept, right? Your third simple tip to help you get started designing really well is pay attention to what colors, shapes, styles, necklines that you are wearing when you receive a lot of compliments from people, whether it's at work or random compliments in the grocery store, anything like that. And just make a mental note of that and or type it into your phone in your notes. Make a running list of what colors are you wearing? What necklines do you wear? How did you fix your hair? Did you use a different makeup that day? Did you sleep well that day? Because sometimes we could wear the wrong colors, but if we ate well and were hydrated and we slept well, that can make up for wearing a really bad neckline because we ourselves are feeling more vibrant. The equal part of that is more balloons, is to pay attention to what you wear when you feel fabulous. What do you wear when you feel sexy, when you feel confident, when you feel vibrant, youthful, intelligent, engaging? Okay, so again, we've got the what and the why, right? Why do you like and not like something? And what are you wearing, hair, makeup, clothing, when you feel great and when you receive a lot of compliments? And if you know those four things, that can save you a lot of creation of things that you really don't care for when it's all said and done versus designing with intention to create dresses that you love or that your clients love. It's when you're doing internet searches for inspiration dresses, right? Which comes back to our So Like a Pro Pinterest. The single biggest thing you can do for yourself, well, two things really. One, set a timer. Search with intention, just like you're designing with intention, and set a timer. And do not ignore that timer when it goes off. Don't keep hitting snooze. If you gave yourself, Joanie's laughing, if you gave yourself 20 minutes or 40 minutes, stop. Why? One, because your entire life should not go down the drain on an internet search, which will lead you to inevitably watching something other about the Aboriginals in Australia, because somehow that came up when you did a search for skate dresses, right? So it will help lengthen your life and your vision because you don't go down the rabbit hole. Two, it makes the time you spend more efficient. And that is part of our design basics. That's part of designing with intention is efficiency. Three is, where are my balloons? Three is that you get overwhelmed. It's just human nature. So if you know that you function best in a 15-minute parameter, great. Do a couple of 15 minutes or do 15 minutes every day. If your brain can do 40 or 50 minutes before it goes and you get cross-eyed, then do that long. But know your limits on when your brain fritzes and then set your timer for that. Or less if you don't have very much time. And that way, as you are looking through dress ideas, you can avoid the overwhelm. Because when you look at 500 Latin dance dresses and you have no idea what you like and dislike, and you have no idea what you look good in, and you've already spent 2 hours scrolling through 2 million pictures, do you think you are going to get any valuable dresses saved out of that to your inspiration board? Or are you literally going to be standing up, your hair standing up straight like Medusa, going, oh my gosh, I just wasted 2 hours of my life. I got nowhere. Right? So set a timer, abide by that. Is anybody in disagreement about the timer thing? It feels really good to do it. It takes discipline, but it feels really good to do it because then you are in control and you are searching with intention like you will design with intention. Look at a dress as independent parts instead of as a whole. You can look in the mirror and say, oh, there's a woman, or oh, there's a man. Or you can look at that person and say, oh, that person has two arms. Oh, wow, that person only has 9 fingers instead of 10 fingers. That person has tiny waist, large hips. That person has long legs, right? So you can break down the dress into smaller bite size pieces, which is crucial. Why? Why? Because again, knowing how to look at something and not just say, oh, I don't like that. Or, oh, wow, I love that. What if you don't love it? What if you really only like one thing out of it? And you make something very similar to that dress and you happen to leave off the one thing that you like, you're going to hate that dress.